Let's move on to the next one. This is about the bad news. So the next talk, I will present what we know right now about the impacts of micro nanoplastic contamination in soil. I show you this one. I don't have to repeat. So 3.5% of total plastic production is used in agriculture, and this produces globally 12 million tons. There are 12 million tons are in use, 5 million tons of waste per year globally, according to the Food and Agriculture Organization. We do not yet have a detailed figure for Norway or for the world, but we try to do an initial estimate of amount of micro nanoplastic that enter European agriculture. So this is a European average. So these are the amount of intentionally released microplastic to agricultural soil. This is a microbeads with a slow release pesticide and fertilizer and so on. We are talking about 5,000 to 35,000 tons per year. Intentional release from biodegradable mulching film, they also produce microplastic. They will not be persistent in soil, but they are transitionally microplastic. 5,000 to 10,000 tons per year. Non-intentional releases, so mismanagement, for example, of mulching film is an important component, 50 to 200,000 tons per year. You see the margin of confidence are very broad because we do not have yet enough data to constrain that uncertainty. Sewage sludge application, 63,000 to 400,000 tons per year. Compost, a European level, between 800 to 21,000 tons per year. Of course, the figure may vary enormously from country to country. This is just an initial guess for Europe. And then there are atmospheric deposition. This is not something that the farmer can control or policymaker can directly control, but it could be a very big source of agricultural soil. What we know that micro nanoplastic contamination in soil is not reversible. They will continue to increase. We need to understand what is the safety operating space for us. How long does it take before we reach a threshold where soil is not anymore healthy and lose, for example, fertility? So it's very urgent. So in total, we have between 200,000 and 2 million tons of micro and nanoplastic added to European soil every year. Plastic like this one, this is an electron microscope image of a fragment from a mulching field. So most of data we have right now on soil contamination come from China. We know that there is an increasing trend in soil globally of this contamination. Agricultural film residues are a very important source of plastic in China because they've been doing a lot of mismanagement. We are working, Papillon is doing that, we are working in monitoring soil in Europe as well. This year, finalize the collection of about 40 soil from Norway, and we will analyze them. The data will be ready next year. This is an example of what we found in Germany. So there is this field treated with this mulching film, and when we look in soil, we found this type of particles that you can see can easily be related to that source. Comparing, this is a soil, the concentration found in soil treated with sewage sludge. We have between up to 83,000 particles per kilogram of soil, which means between 64 gram and almost 1 gram of particles per kilogram of soil. This is a field still in Germany, close by, treated with compost. We have much higher, even 129,000 particles per kilogram. We are up to 2 gram of plastic per kilogram of soil. In comparison, this is a controlled soil where there was no treatment with sludge or with compost, not even with agricultural plastic. The concentration, you have 2,000 particles per kilogram of soil and a few milligrams of plastic per kilogram of soil. So there are differences. The way we treat the soil matters, and this we need to keep in mind. So This is, for example, a soil. This is a particle extracted, polyethylene, extracted from a soil in Spain. After we analyze, we remove the organic matter, we float the plastic, and we can clean up the sample. So from this amount of soil, which is about 100 grams, we obtain all this plastic. This is a case of mismanagement. You can imagine that this contamination can affect the soil property, can affect the fertility. This is not as uncommon and as someone can believe. There is a lot of mismanagement, and this is our first objective, is to try to stop that. There are effects on physical, documented from mostly so far laboratory study, physical property of soil, chemical properties of soil, biological properties of soil. There are, I need to skip the detail, apologies. There are effects on soil organisms that, for example, decrease number of earthworms, decrease diversity of soil fauna, increase mortality. Fauna can also, animals can also move plastic up and down and laterally. These are a review showing that agricultural soil in the upper plot are among the most contaminated one, and that pink bar represent also where that concentration range fit in the curve, sensitivity curve of organisms. So some organisms are affected already at the concentration that are measured in the environment. And there are also effects on plants documented, and mostly still from laboratory study or microbes, and we are working on developing the knowledge on field. Also in this case, we have effects possible at concentration that are observed in the environment. So it seems that we are already in the risk zone. Also, biodegradable plastic produce effects. They are not, let's say, as safe as people has been presented. So the more you dig into the detail of ecotoxicological property, the more effect you find. In fact, that's what we did in one of these mesocosms. We observe effect on plant growth. You can see this, the plot at the lower part. There is an effect, for example, in the number of leaves in lettuce, an effect on other morphological parameter. Yeah. Okay, and that was it. So I showed you this before, and this is my last slide. Thank you very much for your attention. Sorry, I had to rush a little bit. I hope it was clear, and I will be pleased to answer your questions.